Shalom, shalom, Israel. First and foremost, I want to give all honor, glory, and praises to YAHAWAH, BASHIMAMASHIAH, YAHAWASHI, double honors to the elders and apostles of great millstone, and shalom to many Akim and Akwat out there who are diligently waiting to be delivered from this final captivity. And today's topic is going to be entitled, Israel is not Negro only. Okay, so, I've done, other videos on this, but today I honestly felt like I want to do it again. I believe I have some more to say, you know, that I didn't cover in my previous videos. And what inspired me to do this is the fact that, like, Slaki, you can actually, there are actually Israelites, okay, that go around and say, You are only an Israelite if you have dark skin. You are only an Israelite if you are a Negro. Like, those are the prerequisites. If you are half breed, okay, just straight up and down. Even though there's no real such thing as a half breed. I just like using that as a derogatory term. No offense to my brothers, but to my brothers and sisters that have one parent that's an Israelite and one parent that's not, or their father's an Israelite and their mother is not. But if your mother's an Israelite and your father is a heathen, then the half-breed derogatory term is in reference to you. Okay, so, but yeah, it's note to know Israel is not directed towards any Israelites. I try to watch myself. So, the thing is, and honestly, you know, that's pretty crazy, because I know that Israel, Jake that has, you know, two different races of parents, they have it tough, you know. Especially if they're actually Israelites. If their father's an Israelite and they, you know, go out or whatever, or just try to socialize as it starts as children, they have a hard time, because I believe they were saying that, oh, they don't know if they a white mom and a Israelite dad, so-called black dad, have a kid. That kid looks like more brown than darker than his mom, lighter than his dad. Okay, and he tries to go hang out with the black, so-called black kids. Then they reject him because they say, "Oh, you're white." And then if he goes to hang out with the white kids, then they reject him because, oh, you're black, like stuff like that. So yeah, they have it hard. Once again, no disrespect to my brothers and sisters that are like that, but are actually Israelites on their father's side. But all disrespect to people that are like that, but are but their Israelite is on their mother's side. Okay, so, what I want to go into today, I have this article out. This brother is from the Dominican Republic. Okay, so I don't even know what tribe that is exactly. I know it's not Issachar, or maybe it is. Let me check it right quick. Dominican Republic, Simeon. Okay, so he is from the tribe of Simeon. All right. he's from the tribe of Simeon. In 2017, just shot. That just sounds wrong. Slack, yeah. Basically, he just like made a huge upset and won an entire tournament. won an entire tournament in Street Fighter V. Okay, now, firstly, I want to, and he used a character that people widely said was a bad character or a weak character. This is back in 2017, okay? So, with that, you know, he found techniques or methods or whatever that other people had not yet discovered yet, and he made his way beating a whole bunch of top players that were very skilled, okay? And what this article is saying from scholarly gamers, they were saying that the Dominican Republic, it has a lot of strong players, but because most of them, they don't, it's very hard for them to travel, you know. Israel, you know, we're impoverished, you know, meaning, you know, we don't have enough, we don't have a lot of money. Impoverished, meaning of a person or area made poor. You know, Dominican Republic is generally impoverished. You know, they don't have a lot of money to travel, so they weren't able to show that there are good players in the Dominican Republic. Okay, so then Mena RD, as well as just primarily Mena, which is his name, Saul Mena, that's his name, he went to a tournament, and a very big tournament where there was a bunch of good players there, and he basically beat everyone except for one player, and I think it was a Japanese or a Korean, I forgot where he's from. He beat everyone, and then when he got to, I believe his name is Tokido, the Japanese or Korean player, he lost, and Tokido sent him to loser's bracket, and then Mena made a loser's run all the way to grand finals, and then I believe they said he won. Where is it? Skipping down. In game four, he did. He actually won the entire tournament. Yeah, right there. He won the entire tournament. He beat literally everyone, and that was, I think that I believe that was like his first like major tournament. So he just came out, and then he had said he had been studying and finding out methods to beat most of the players except for some of them. One of them was a guy named Knuckledew, who was a American Asian. I don't know what exactly he's from, but he said that if he had played against him, he was not ready for him. So with that in mind, okay, you know, that just goes to show the whole, and he was 18 at the time, I believe. It really just goes to show the whole, what's the word called? I believe talent and the amazing, the fact that Israel is a salt of the earth, okay? Matthew 5 and 13, ye are the salt of the earth, but if the salt have lost his savor, wherewith shall it be salted? It is thenceforth good for nothing but to be cast out and to be trodden under foot of men. Okay, so Israel is the salt of the earth, and he's not even the only example. As a matter of fact, there's two other examples of Israelites just dominating tournaments. World record tournament wins. Zero? Yeah, he had got the world record for the most consecutive tournament wins in a row. Okay, he just kept on when he just did not lose for such a long period of time. Okay, and they were all like good players there. All right, and then on top of that, Mena, what he did without prior experience or like hands-on experience per se is the proper term. Mena just beat a whole bunch of people, and you know, he got a major tournament win. Zero Gonzalo, or whatever his full name is, Gonzalo Barrios, he had the most consecutive streak of tournament wins. Okay, and let me get what he looks like. There, here he's Chile. He's from Chile, so South America. You know, another one of the tribes, I believe. Right there, Naftali. He's from Naftali. He's from the tribe of Naftali, and then Sonic Fox, who it looks like Judah. He got the most diversity in games. He could play like a bunch of different games, and he won multiple different tournaments, like I think in the same day. So again, as I read Matthew 5 verse 13, ye are the salt of the earth. Okay, the salt of the earth. You know what that expression? I don't know where I can find the thing. I think there was another. Okay, right there. People who are described as the salt of the earth are those who are considered to be of great worth and reliability. So, of great worth is the key thing. Sonic Fox, and Gonzalo, these three pulled off amazing feats. Okay, those were not easy things to do. They may have been playing video games, but a lot of people, you know, prepare and stuff like that to go and compete. Okay, it's not no child's play. It's very, very hard. All right, I know, because I've had my share of, you know, playing tournaments, and I won a few tournaments. I won like fourth place in a few ones, but it wasn't like super player, like more like mid, because you know I never went to those big, you know, super tournaments or whatever, but I did, you know, get to experience that whole environment of how serious these players are. All right, and another thing, look at he's copying something off of a manga. This looks hard as shit, and if anyone says that this is easy, please try and do the same thing. Like this. Yeah, okay. Yeah, hold yourself up, okay? Like, nah. I just thought, like, this was a very, very crazy thing. Cool thing to add. But, Romans chapter 8 verse 6, for to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Okay, it's you're being carnally minded if you're just saying, oh, that person has dark skin, then they're then they're an Israelite. Or that person has a white skin, they're a heathen. You can't, you cannot be saying that, okay? And as a matter of fact, just because he has that skin color, or is, yeah, he's a little darker, but just because he has this skin color doesn't mean he's an Edomite or anything like that, okay? Don't be carnally minded, all right? How do you determine who is an Israelite and who is not? Okay, I went over this before, but let's go over it again. Numbers chapter 1, verse 18, if it would load. Numbers chapter 1, verse 18. And they assembled all the congregation together on the first day of the second month, and they declared their pedigrees after their families by the house of their fathers, according to the numbers of their names from 20 years old and upwards by their polls. So the thing is, they declared their pedigrees after their families by the house of their fathers, meaning that you are what your father is. Okay, As I was mentioning earlier in this video, how I like to call a certain group of people half breeds. Again, there's no such thing as a half breed. There's no such thing as mix. Okay, you are just an Israelite. You are just an Edomite. You're just whatever race you are, and that is determined by your father. And it, obviously, if it's determined by your father, and if your father is seemingly mixed as well, then it goes by his father, and then you keep on going back, keep on going up the line of their father in order to determine, okay, this person is an Israelite. Because if you keep on going back, you'll see that Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob are the one, it is from their lineage, okay? Obviously, we can't do that now, but for the people, that's a first, step to determining who is an Israelite. But there's also another step, okay? Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 27, and the Most High shall scatter you among the nation, and you shall be left few in number among the heathen, whither the Lord shall lead you. Okay, so, Slakia, Israel shall be scattered among the nations. Okay, so now when, I made a heredity chart about this, a makeshift, not real heredity chart. I really hope I can get this out. But basically, Slaki, I'm trying to find the chart. Okay, well, okay, so I'll just explain it verbally. So if, let's say, a so-called black man, okay, who's dark as fucking, I'm trying to think of a good example. Steph Curry. Let's just say Steph Curry. Because I use Blake Griffin a lot. So let's say his father, father, look at this. This looks like blackface, by the way. But look at how dark his father is. His father got with a white, or here, better pictures. His father got with an Edomite, okay? And then this is how he, you know, he came out. Okay, his skin looks light, but, well, his father looks like light too, but we see, even though his skin is light, we know, we because we have knowledge, as we see right here, his father is an Israelite. We know that Steph Curry is an Israelite, okay? And if Steph Curry, let me get that, his wife, if his wife is an Edomite, which one is, okay? Who is? All right, whatever. Let me just use Blake Griffin. I always use this guy. Blake Griffin, wife. There, okay? So his, if his wife, because Blake Griffin's, oh my God, let me prove it first. And you can see in my search history, Irie went to him multiple times, okay? So, again, look at how dark his father is. Look at his Edomite mother. And look at Blake Griffin. Then now if you go look at Blake Griffin's wife. And then his wife isn't Edomite. I think that's his wife. Okay. And then look at Blake Griffin's kid. He looks, his kid looks like an Edomite. You got Blake Griffin looking like an Edomite. He looks like an Edomite, even though he's an Israelite. Okay? And then you got him with a white, an Edomite woman. Okay? And then look at his Edomite look. This looks like, bro, okay, Slakia. No one can tell me that if they saw this kid, okay, without prior knowledge to Blake Griffin and his father, you cannot tell me you would say that's an Israelite. That's easy. That's an Israelite. No. No, you cannot say that. This boy looks like an Edomite. That is straight up and down looking like an Edomite. But that is not an Edomite. Okay? It may seem very dominant because he doesn't have like dark skin, but that is both of them are Israelites, okay? All because the father of Blake Griffin was an Israelite, okay? And as we know, you declare your pedigrees by the house of your father. Okay, so if Blake's father was an Israelite, Blake is an Israelite, regardless of what he looks like. So if this kid, whatever his name is, father is an Israelite, Blake Griffin, then this boy, as much as he looks like an Edomite, is an Israelite, all right? Now, keep that in mind. All right, keep that in mind. Slakia. All right, now, as I mentioned in Deuteronomy 4 and 27, the Most High would scatter us among the nations, okay? So, if we're scattered among the nations, okay? Say, for example, I'm amongst, perfect example. I'm among the Chinese, all right? Now, if I am living in China, okay, as I am now, so-called dark-skinned Jake, Judah, okay, and I get with a so-called Chinese woman, which is the Moabites, or with the Moabite woman, okay, my child will come out looking like whatever combination of genes. Oh, and whatever. So he'll be a dark-skinned, Moabite-looking child. And then because, again, we're still living in China, okay, there's the only, or excuse me, mostly there's going to be Moabite women amongst me. So the chances of me and my son getting with a Moabite woman is going to be very high. Slakia, very high. And then as time goes on, you know, the next generation, you keep on going to the next generation. I have a kid. My kid has a kid. His kid has a kid. You know, and you keep on going down like that. And they keep on getting with the same, another Moabite woman, then over and over, the appearance is going to look more like the other nation, okay? Which is because starting from me, let's quote unquote say purebred Israelite, which obviously I'm not, I wouldn't say I'm purebred. But starting from me, just for the sake of an example, I'd say I am a purebred 100% Judite. And then I get with a 100% purebred Moabite woman, then that so-called half-breed is going to get with another 100% purebred Moabite woman, and they keep on going down, and it's going to look more and more like the other nation, okay? And then we're going to eventually get to a so-called Israelite looking like a so-called Moabite, okay? So it could, let's say, two or three generations after me, then it's going, the great grandson or the great great grandson is going to look like a so-called Moabite. Okay, he's going to look like Jet Li or whatever. Okay, which I believe I heard people saying that a brother saying they believe Bruce Lee was an Israelite. I think Bruce Lee's dead now. Bruce Lee? Is it Bruce Lee? Bruce Lee. Yeah, Bruce Lee. But another thing is, I'll get to this in a bit. Yet there's also this type of I guess mixing. Not really mixing, but the fact that the kid will look like the other nation, this is basically what you would call a Gentile, but they're still an Israelite, okay? And I'm gonna show that in here, John 7, verse 33. Then said YAHAWASHI unto them, and notice this is YAHAWASHI, yet a little while am I with you, and then I go unto him that sent me. Ye shall seek me and shall not find me, and where I am, thither ye cannot come. Then said the Jews among themselves, whither will he go that we shall not find him? Will he go unto the dispersed among the Gentiles and teach the Gentiles? Okay, it said, will he go unto the dispersed? Slocky, oh my God, I just remembered a conversation I was having with someone about this. But will he go unto the dispersed among the Gentiles and teach the Gentiles? Okay, so Why would he go teaching the Gentiles? Okay, because look at this. Matthew chapter 15, verse 24. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. YAHAWASHI is not sent but only to the Israelites. All right? So, like, why would he go? Why would they think that he's going to go and teach to the Gentiles? But it's in this wording. Okay? Will he go into the dispersed among the Gentiles? Okay, meaning the dispersed of the lost sheep of the house of Israel, the dispersed Israelites. Okay, which we go back and we see. Where is it? Deuteronomy 4:27, and the Most High shall scatter you among the nations. Okay, among as Israel scattered, you know, they initially looked like, say, dark skin or whatever, but now they look different. Okay. That's where something that I honestly feel, or to my knowledge, I don't see Israelites teaching to the other nations, but I believe honestly it's primarily the fact that, number one, if I try to, like, if, say, for example, you try to search, I could actually try searching. No. Well, I'll try searching in a bit. If you try to search in, like, say, in France or Chinese, for example, then you would, maybe you could find it, but I don't. But I think it's more so the fact that the language barrier. So it would be a lot harder, unless they are teaching in these other in all the scattered, in all the other nations, and, you know, just we just don't have access to be able to know of it. But I will say, I did see a brother preaching in, I think it was the Philippines or Taiwan, one of those two countries. So, yeah, brothers are, you know, trying to, you know, preach and spread this word. And again, that's if how are we going to just say, oh, or how are you going to how would you teach the Gentiles, okay, if you Slakia, you go out to teach the Gentiles and you only you don't see any so-called Jakes over there, you just only see the other nations. But that's the thing, that's the reason why I brought this up, because if you go to the other nations, you'll the those that actually are able to receive it, those are actually able to receive this message, you know, that those are Israelites, okay? Just not, let me actually get that. Matthew chapter 22, verse 14, for many are called, but few are chosen. Oh, yeah, so that was basically it then. Matthew chapter 22, verse 14, for many are called, but few are chosen. Not everyone is going to be able to comprehend, not everyone's going to be able to actually be able to receive this word, all right? And but let's go into another precept. Second Ezra chapter 3 verse 36, thou shalt find that Israel by name hath kept thy precepts, but not the heathen. Okay, so again, even further proof that it's a very spiritual thing, because only the Israelites, okay? So if you see someone that looks like an Edomite, all right, if you see someone that looks like an Edomite keeping the commandments, or Edomite looking brothers, because there, I believe there's one in a GMS, so-called Edomite looking brother, but they're actually Israelite, that is actually, you know, sincerely preaching this truth, or preaching this truth to my knowledge. I don't keep up with them, all right? And then look at another thing is again, going back into Matthew 5 and 13, ye are the salt of the earth. Okay, look at this. Watch this video right quick. And also, quick thing, notice the song choice, okay, that they're dancing to. Just letting you know. You feel good? There's so much bone. To be honest, at the very bare minimum, I believe the middle girl in the yellow pants is without a doubt an Israelite. Let me actually open full screen. This person over here, if you can see behind this second girl, I don't know if that's a guy or a girl, whatever. I don't think that they're an Israelite, but maybe some of these other ones are. But the middle one, definitely, in my speaking as a man. Hey, yeah. You're getting down. Or these three. One, this woman, this, and then this woman. Look at him. We're gonna have a bunk good time. We're gonna have a bunk good time. We're gonna have a bunk good time. Oh yeah. So yeah, honestly, one of the lock. Yeah, I don't have the full video, but one of the brothers was saying, like, one of the brothers actually brought out a precept at how I believe it was King David that was dancing for the Most High. He was making a point that, you know, only Israel can truly dance. Okay, and honestly, I think this, at this girl, the girl in the yellow pants, the girl in the red, whatever design, dress, and the girl in the black and brown checkerboard clothes, I believe they were actually dancing. So, at the bare minimum, you know, with how the freaking camera is landscape, and just it's not really good quality or whatever, but overall, like, I mean, I couldn't see, I didn't look at most of them. I tried, I saw one of them that I feel like did not really dance that well, but, you know, that's just a rambling. I honestly believe that they, at least maybe half of them are Israelites, all right? But let me try to see, you know, amongst, for you guys to see if we can find Israelites, okay? Shit. Okay. What the frick is this? Oh, that was wrong. Dang. Okay. Let me start over. Slakia, bear with me. Okay, I'm gonna try one more time. Okay, Slakia. Okay, well, again, I try. These are some weird ass videos that is allowable on YouTube, and my ass gets copyright strike for every single video that I make. Okay, wow. Anyway, I tried, apparently no, I guess not. What the frick? What is this? Huh. Well, I tried. So, yeah, with that, I hope this lesson was, well, I think there's more. Nope. No. Okay, yeah, but that's basically it. I hope this lesson was edifying. I hope this, you know, really opens your, you brother's eyes and allows you to think more spiritually. Don't think, okay, yo, just because they don't look like they're dark skin or whatever, they don't look like a Negro, just because they don't look like a Negro doesn't mean they're not an Israelite, okay? Don't think that, acknowledge, we need to actually acknowledge that, you know, there could be, you know, an Israelite through the spirit that looks like the other nation. And you need to be mindful of that and don't go, you know, cursing out people that, you know, look like that, look like the other nation, but are actually, you know, that are actually like maybe feel, maybe they feel so like they need to, they're being called to it. Okay. They're being returned to their roots because, as I mentioned before, you know, the continued constant, getting with the heathens can make your future generations look like the other nations. All right. But with that, I hope this lesson was edifying. I want to give all honor, glory, and praises to the Most High Yahweh, by Hashem HaMashiach, YAHAWASHI, double honor to the elders and apostles of great millstone. And with that, I want to say Shalom.